aimed at the heart of Berlin could end the war by Christmas.
The concept for a broad landing at Normandy has been approved. Given the political sensibilities involved, there's no going back on that.
You're the supreme commander. The politics are your concern. My interest is the most effective strategy and the tactical moves to support it. A massive invasion will be tipped to Jerry's intelligence, we know that. He'll be ready to defend across a broad front. A slashing blow will be harder for him to concentrate his troops against with any depth.
Unless the German knows where the slashing blow is coming, then, as you put it, with his intelligence alerted...
You're being inflexible.
I'm adhering to a master plan. Once we have established the beachhead, we can re-examine our options.
I see. And as commander of all land forces, I'll have my say in that re-examination?
Absolutely. Now, let me outline my expectations for your ground forces once ashore. Here, the ground slopes easily.
Sir, it wouldn't take more than 15 minutes.
15 minutes better spent on real work, Captain.
With respect, sir, public relations is real work. Sir, I know you don't have much time for the press, but the folks back home need to know who you are. Human face of their leader, sir.
Mr. Roosevelt is their leader, and mine.
But, sir...
Have them interview division commanders. Try some platoon sergeants. What about my chief of staff here, General Smith? What do you say, Beetle? You want to show the world your human face?
Sorry, sir. It wasn't issued one.
This isn't MacArthur's HQ, where he has to be at the center of everything. We're a team here. So go get some publicity for the running backs. That is all.
Yes, sir.
He's arrived.
I saw. I could hardly miss it. Beetle, he's brilliant, but sometimes he acts like a child.
Are you thinking of sending him home?
Let's have him.
He'll see you now. You gonna keep the helmet on, General?
Damn right.
I think you know why you're here.
More or less. Some prep head politician stateside got pissed at the truth.
That's neither more nor less, George. It's damned ignorant. Anglo-Saxons to rule a post-war world. What the hell is that?
The straight skinny. When this is over, it will be us and the Brits have to put the damn world back together.
That's going to come as a hell of a surprise to Joe Stalin, who's losing millions on the Eastern Front.
Communism's for the next war.
God damn it, George. Shut up. The Czechs are also in this war, and the Dutch, and the Danes, and God knows who else. And above all, it's racialism. It's the very thing we're fighting. I can't have my general spouting idiocy. Hitler would applaud. Anglo-Saxon superiority, that's exactly the kind of pig-headed crap that'll make Stalin think we are the next enemy. Sometimes I think you don't have the vaguest idea why we're fighting this war.
That's not fair, Ike.
It is if it's true. I'm not sending a bunch of fresh young kids from Iowa and California and New York and Nebraska to die on French beaches for the freedom of people they know nothing about so we can establish a new racial order. I'm asking them to die to prevent precisely that. And they're ready to do it. And that's why they're heroes. And why slapping a shell-shocked soldier as a malinger is never, never permissible. Do you understand me, sir? You should know, despite the fact that he doubts your worthiness to command, that General Marshall has left it to me to decide how to handle this, so I ask you again. Do you understand?
Sir, yes, sir, I understand completely. I do, Ike, I swear I do. When I don't get all stuffy, I promise. I swear, I promise. Just please, don't send me home. Please, Ike. Couldn't bear to be in Washington when the big show starts. Don't do that to me. I beg you. Soldier to soldier, and I'll keep my mouth shut, I promise you. Soldier to soldier.
Soldier to soldier. I wish it were that simple. You were my mentor. My senior officer who told me once a long time ago that one day I'd be giving him orders. Well, that day's come, George. And that's the truth. Soldier to soldier. Last time, Georgie. Last time.
Thank you.
Sir, may I return to my headquarters now? Gentlemen. Played him like a violin. Ate out of my hand, he did. Drive on.
How'd it go?
I'm keeping him on. Probably thinks he put one over on me. Hell, maybe he did. That's keep him in Maidenhead, commanding his fictitious army. El Rommel thinks he's my ace. Besides, once we get ashore, I'll need him. To command real tanks. So, Traff, what you got?
Early estimates of airborne losses.